Hello friends, welcome to my channel Technical Education to solve technical problems. In this video, you are going to learn how to set tappet on 4-cylinder engine, what is valve overlap condition and how to find TDC compression stroke for number 1 cylinder, how to find TDC compression stroke for number 4 cylinder, tappet sequence in 2 rounds. To adjust the tappet, first you have to mark intake and exhaust valve on your rocker arm shafter or rocker arms. After marking intake and exhaust, you have to bring number 4 cylinder at valve overlap condition. Here you can see it's the valve overlap condition. Valve overlap condition is when your intake valve is opening and the exhaust valve is just closed, and when moving the crank back and forth, your intake and exhaust valve will move simultaneously. In the first round, you will adjust number 1 cylinder intake and exhaust, number 2 cylinder intake and number 3 cylinder exhaust valve. To set the tappet, you have to learn this dragging movement. You have to learn how to feel the dragging movement of the tappet gauge or the feeler gauge, and then you can easily adjust the valves. During this movement, you have to feel the dragging feeling on upper and lower side of the feeler gauge. First, we are going to adjust the exhaust valve on the 1 cylinder. And then we will adjust the intake valve of number 1 cylinder. As I have already told you, in the first round, we will adjust with number 1 cylinder at TDC compression stroke, number 1 cylinder exhaust intake, number 2 cylinder intake, and number 3 cylinder exhaust valve. Now we will adjust intake valve of number 1 cylinder. First, you have to remove the lock nut and then adjust the screw, the screwdriver, as you need according to your tappet gauge. The clearance, the valve clearance, is given by the manufacturer in the engine's manual. We are adjusting it at 30 and 45 mm intake and exhaust valve. Now, number 1 cylinder intake and exhaust valve are adjusted. Number 1 cylinder is on the front of the engine, and after that we are going to adjust number 2 cylinder intake valve. Here you can see number 2 cylinder intake valve is being adjusted. Use the screwdriver to adjust valve clearance according to the tappet gauge. Remember that the valve clearance is already decided by the engine manufacturer. After locking the nut, recheck the clearance. If you are feeling any difference in the dragging movement of the feeler gauge, you can readjust the tappet, readjust the knob lock nut. Now we adjusting the exhaust valve of number 3 cylinder. That is the front of the engine, number 1 cylinder intake exhaust, number 2 cylinder intake and exhaust, and then number 3 cylinder exhaust, intake and exhaust. And we are adjusting the number 3 cylinder exhaust valve. Adjust the screw or adjuster according to your feeler gauge. Now in the first row we have adjusted number 1 cylinder intake and exhaust valve, number 2 cylinder intake valve, and number 3 cylinder exhaust valve. Number 1 cylinder intake exhaust, number 2 cylinder intake, and number 3 cylinder exhaust valve has been adjusted. So we will rotate the engine 360 degree and after rotating engine 360 degree we will adjust the second set of the valves. We have marked on the fan and the body of the engine and rotating the engine 360 degree. Number 1 cylinder will be at the valve overlap condition. Here you can see the exhaust valve is slowly closing and as the exhaust valve closes the engine is in valve overlap condition at number 1 cylinder. Number 1 cylinder is at valve overlap condition. Here you can see by moving crankshaft back and forth, both valves are moving up and down, intake and exhaust. There you can see the fan is back in line with the body. The marking on the fan and the body are in line. It means that we can adjust intake and exhaust of numbers 2 and 3 valve and the 4 cylinder intake exhaust. Intake and exhaust of number 4 cylinder, number 3 cylinder intake, and number 2 cylinder exhaust valve will be adjusted this time. That is the exhaust valve we are adjusting of number 2 cylinder. After adjusting the exhaust valve of number 2 cylinder, let me adjust the intake valve of number 3 cylinder. Remember the sequence. In first round, number 1 cylinder intake and exhaust, number 2 cylinder intake, number 3 cylinder exhaust. And in second round, we will adjust number 4 cylinder intake and exhaust, number 2 cylinder exhaust, and number 3 cylinder intake valve. That is the last valve we are going to adjust, the intake valve of number 4 cylinder, and our 8 valves will be adjusted, or valve clearance will be adjusted for our 8 valves. 4 cylinder engine, 8 valves. Now after adjusting the clearance of the valve or tappet clearance, we are going to start the engine and check if it is running smoothly or not. Subscribe to the channel for more videos like that.